الصالحين والأمين والإخوان النبيين والمرسلين رضي الله عنهم وحاشي المؤمنين ولبيت الطاهرين وللخلفاء الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وللأئمة المهتدين أبي حنيفة ومالك وشافي وأحمد وللأولياء والصالحين رضوان الله أجمعين. قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: عليكم بسنتي وسنة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين تمسكوا بها وعدوا عليها بالنواجذ. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما تركت شيئا إلا أمرتكم به. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he sent the prophets, the messengers, he also had some people who were selected. Ye khas chune hue jo unke saathi banenge, sahaba banenge, hamari yun banenge. They will become their partners. Kyunki is mission ko complete karna jo nabiyon ke upar diya gaya tha Allah ta'ala ne. So what the mission which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to all the prophets, like Ibrahim alayhi salam, you have Isa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, you have all these prophets which came, and every single one of them had a mission to complete. And the first and sabse pehla jo mission tha wo tawheed of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala ki tawheed jo hai thi wo dunya mein leke aana, to get the message clear that there is only one worthy of our worship, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is worthy of worship. So sabse pehla ye zaruri ye peygham jo bheja tha. The first message was to give the message of Tawheed. Similarly, the Sahaba Ikram, the Hawariyun, their job was to support that. Unka jo Sahaba Ikram the, unka mission ye tha ki jo sunnat hai Rasool ki, usko zinda rakhna, usko mazbooti se thamna, har waqt mein, jab tak wo zinda the, wo unhone sunnat Rasool ko zinda kiya. They lived the sunnah. یہ صرف نام نہیں تھا جیسے کہ اس زمانے میں people will call themselves اہل سنت کہنے والے کافی ہیں لیکن سنت کے اوپر عمل کرنے والے بہت کم ہیں. They won't live their life according to the sunnah, but they are the first to say ہم اہل سنت وال جماعت. So first of all, what is اہل سنت وال جماعت؟ یہ لفظ جو ہے اہل سنت وال جماعت یہ کہاں سے آیا؟ Where did this word of اہل سنت وال جماعت actually come from? This was the first time it was narrated to us by Ibn Abbas رضی اللہ عنہ. سب سے پہلی مرتبہ یہ جو لفظ اہل سنت والجماعت، یعنی کہ جس کو آج کل ہم سنی بھی کہتے ہیں سنی، اصل جو لفظ ہے وہ اہل سنت والجماعت ہے، یہ حضرت ابن عباس رضی اللہ عنہ سے آیا. اور اس کی تفسیر کیا ہے؟ اہل سنت کا مطلب جو سنت رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم کو پکڑ کے رکھے، جیسے کہ رسول صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم نے فرمایا: علیکم بسنتی وسنت الخلفاء الراشدین تمسکوا بها وعدوا علیہ بالنواجذ. اے لوگوں، ایسے زمانے کے فتنے آئیں گے تمہارے اوپر لازم ہے کہ تم میرے سنت کو پکڑ کے رکھو. So in the times of fitna, when you will see many people different of opinions, there will be people saying, oh, you need to do this. اب یہ آپ کی یہ رائے ہے. So there will people become with different opinions in every time and every era. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the matter very clear to us that you must hold on to my sunnah and the way of the sahaba ikram as well. This is very, very important. So this is the meaning of ahli sunnah. But in every time you will have different people who will also claim to be ahli sunnah, and they will not be from the sunnah. They will not be following the sunnah. What is opposite of the sunnah? This is a question which is a very important question we need to realize. What is the opposite of the word sunnah? Is the word bid'ah. The word bid'ah is completely opposite. Just like you have the opposite of right is the left, the opposite of darkness is light. The opposite of sunnah is bid'ah. This is very, very important to realize, because if we don't know the opposite, then we could be calling like sunnah, so following saying that we are the Sunnis and we are Ahl Sunnah wal Jamaat, whilst we are actually opposing the sunnah by our own actions. Now, bid'ah is two types of bid'ah. Bid'ah is of how much types? Two types. Number one is what happened in the early stages after the time of the Tabi'een. The early times, they were the sects which created bid'ah in the Aqidah. One bid'ah is in Aqidah and one is in the actions of worship. So one is bid'ah which is in relation to Aqidah, and one bid'ah is which is in relation to your worship, like Salah, Zakat, and all these things. So that is separate. So I'll explain the first one. The first one, for example, the Qadariyah. the Qadariyya ye ek aisa ek firqa jo bana tha jo taqreeban 300 saal baad Rasoolullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ke baad to ye jo ek firqa jo bana tha ye inhone taqdeer ko jhutla diya ke taqdeer ye kaise ho sakti hai Allah taala ko sab pata hai to phir hum to majboor ho jayenge so they didn't accept that taqdeer in the first place so these were bid'ah they innovated they added their own way of thinking into the religion of Islam which the Prophet didn't mention So this was not from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. They made these things up. So they made their own sects by their own aqidah issues. Similarly were the Murjiyah, and then there was the Mu'tazila. The second type of bid'ah, which is in relation to fi'liyah, the actions. So for example, anything which the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't do in terms of actions. So these would be bid'ah. Like for example, somebody wanted to read four rakat of Fajr namaz, of the Faraz. So he said that I'm feeling very pious today, so I'm going to read four rakat of Fajr namaz, of the Faraz. How many Faraz are there of Fajr? There's two Faraz. So you can't say that, I feel more pious today. What do you think would be of them other two rakat that he prays, which the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't do? So there's two things here. Number one is your intention. Your niyat has to be correct. It has to be for the sake of Allah. This is the number one criteria for your a'mal to be accepted. That's number one. Number two, for your a'mal to be accepted, it must be according to the sunnah. It must be according to the sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ, for that was the reason of why Allah sent the Prophet in the first place. Oh, Allah could have even sent Jibreel alayhi salam. He could have said, Jibreel alayhi salam, you go and convey the message. But he wanted a living example. So we could live and reflect in every situation of our life into the Rasulullah ﷺ. Whatever we go through, we have a living example who was a human being and he went through hardships and he could feel pain just like we feel pain. How did he go through it? That's how when we look and reflect into the seed of Rasulullah ﷺ, we are able to know that he is the example of all of mankind. Number two, it needs to be according to the sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ. You cannot make your own ways of worship. I cannot say today, well, the Prophet ﷺ, he went to the Miraj. So from now on, let's make another Eid. He went to the Miraj. Yes, the event happened. So somebody said now, let's make another Eid. The Prophet ﷺ went to the Miraj. You can't do this. Why? Because this is the foundation of Islam. The festivals are the foundation of every religion. So those who innovate into that, they are adding bid'ah, they're adding their own ways of how they should be living the Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned everything clearly. He said, "Man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fa rad." Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Anyone who innovates into our religion, into the matters which I and the Sahaba ikram have not done, will be rejected." That was clear from Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So anything which is in relation to the deen, you cannot add. Sometimes when you see, like for example, many people, they say that, "Oh, how is it that you are celebrating, for example, the 14th of August, the Yom-e Azadi? You are doing that, right? But when it comes to the Prophet's birthday, you're not celebrating it." So we need to focus on the hadith again. What does the hadith say? Anyone who innovates into the religion, is the Yom-e Azadi anything to do with the? Is it has anything to do with the religion? No. This is your own personal issues. So when it's your own personal issues, you can celebrate them. These are all your own ways. When it comes into the matters of the religion, you cannot add anything. This is what is meant by the hadith, "Man ahdatha fi amrina hadha ma laysa minhu fa rad." This is the meaning. So when, for example, it comes to graduation, are you allowed to celebrate graduation? Yes. This is your own personal achievement. You have achieved something. You are allowed to celebrate this. But when it comes to the religion, then it cannot. Because the Prophet made it clear, you cannot add anything to the religion. I have come to complete your religion. Rasulullah says, "Ma taraktu shay'an illa umirtukum bih." I have not left out anything which will bring you closer to Jannah and will take you away from the hellfire, except that I have told you. I have made matters clear for you. I have told you the deen like a clear barren land. Like a clear barren land. Where a barren land, when you can see it, it's very clear. From far, far miles the distance, you can see it is very flat. Rasulullah ﷺ said that I have left the religion like that. Very clear to you. very clear. The Sirati Mustaqim is very clear. Follow my ways and the ways of the Sahaba Ikram. Now when we look into these bid'ats of what is happening today, in today's time, we see that the people who are copying, they are copying the nations before them. They follow the Christians. They are doing mushabahat with them. So they, at one point, they decided, we are going to celebrate the birthday of Jesus. So what did our people start to do? We are going to start celebrating the birthday of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They said, we are going to start putting lights on. When our people said, we are also going to start putting lights on. When they said, we are going to have trees, we're going to have Christmas trees, our people said, we're going to have Eid Milaad al-Nabi trees. So you see, they are following them inch by inch. As Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, لَتَتَّبَعُنَّ سُنَنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ شِبْرًا بِشِبْرٍ زِرَاعًا بِزِرَاعٍ حَتَّى لَوْ جَحْرُ جُهْرَ الدَّبِّ لَتَبِئْتُمُهُ. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that indeed, definitely there will be a time from my nation. There will be people who will follow the nations before them, inch by inch, handspan by handspan, they will follow them. So the Sahaba Ikram asked, which nations are you talking about? Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned, and they asked, is it the Christians you're talking about? Is it the Jews? He said, who else? Who else? Liman, who else is it? It is the Christians who you are, and that's what we see today. We are following their ways, we are heading toward whatever they went toward, and to look at the state of them today. Look how much of their churches are empty, because this is what bid'ah does. This is what innovation into the religion does. And similarly, when we look into the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ismail alayhi salam, they built the Kaaba. And if you look in the tafsir, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَدُرُهُ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ, when it's mentioned under the tafsir that they worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who cannot give them any harm, they can give them no benefit. So under this tafsir, if you look at this, it is mentioned in the books of tafsir that they were people at the time of Ibrahim alayhi salam, they were all on tawheed. Sab tawheed ki upar the Ibrahim alayhi salam ke zamane mein. When it comes later on, the time before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, isko zamanah fatrat kehte hain, zamanah fatrat. Zamanah fatrat ka maana ke ye us waqt ka zamana hai ke ek jo pichle jo nabi tha uska jo paigham hai, uska jo risala hai, wo khatam ho chuka hai. It's almost finished. Kuch hai din, jaise jo mushrikeen jo makkah wale the, the people of the Quraysh, they used to have the hajj. They still used to do hajj from Ibrahim alayhi salam. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, thousands of years ago, all the prophets came where? They came Israel, they came to Israel. Musa alayhi salam, Musa bin Isa alayhi salam, sab ke sab nabi wahan par aaye. Makkah mein to koi aaye ko nahi. There was nothing after Ismail alayhi salam, there was nothing there. So for so many thousands of years, they didn't have no message there. Wahan koi paigham hi nahi tha, there was no message there. So what happened was, now these people started to astray from the sunnah. They started to go away from the message which Ibrahim alayhi salam and Ismail alayhi salam had told them. It mentions under the tafsir that these people had made a small bid'ah. These people, the Quraysh of Makkah, they made a small bid'ah, and they said, the aaj ke baad jo tawaf karne aayega Makkah mein, Kaaba ka jo tawaf karega, usko ihram Makkah se hi lena padega. You have to get the ihram from where? From Makkah. They can't bring it from outside. Lekin Ibrahim alayhi salam ye nahi kaha. Ibrahim alayhi salam didn't teach them this. Ismail alayhi salam didn't teach them this. So they innovated the bidat thi unki. So they innovated into the religion thinking, choti si bidat hai, kya hai? So only small thing. Ihram yahan se Makkah se lenge. You can't bring your apna ihram, aap wahan se nahi le sakte. Tafsir ki kitab mein likha hua hai, what happened now when there were people coming to Makkah, they had to buy the ihram from there. But then there were some people who couldn't buy the ihram from there. They didn't have enough money to buy the ihram from Makkah. And what happened next? Now they said, you have to take off this ihram and you have to do tawaf naked. This is in the kitabs. It is in the narrations. There were 360 idols around the Kaaba, and at that time they had to do tawaf naked around the Kaaba. Who was laughing at them? Unke upar kaun has raha tha? Who's laughing at them? Shaitan. Ek choti si bidat ki wajah se kahan pahunch gaye Rasoolullah sallam ke zamane se pehle? Kahan se kahan pahunch gaye? So mere bhaiyo, as the first point to mention is bid'at, they always seem very small. Bid'ah will seem very small. But later on in the next nation, next generation, it will be a completely different religion. جیسے کہ ابراہیم علیہ السلام کے زمانے سے زمانہ فطرت تک بالکل ایک دل الگ دین ہو گیا تھا. They were on the توحید at the time of Ibrahim علیہ السلام and then at the time of just before the Prophet صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم زمانہ فطرت, they were on a completely different way. They had lost their ways. Why? Because of the small bid'ah. By adding into the religion, slowly keep changing it. Exactly the same way we see it today. We see that the people are adding into the religion whatever they feel like. So they add like another festival. Rasulullah صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم made it very clear, there are only two Eid, Eid al-Adha or Eid al-Fitr. آج جو ہمارے لوگ ہیں یہ ایک کو عید کر لیتے ہیں بھائی, کوئی بات نہیں یار, ہم بھی عاشق رسول ہیں. عاشق رسول وہ ہے جو اہل سنت وال جماعت ہے. اہل سنت وال جماعت کا میں نے ڈیفینیشن آپ کو بتایا, اس کا ڈیفینیشن ہے جو سنت کی سنت رسول اور صحابہ کرام کے طریقے کے اوپر چلنے والے ہیں. They are those who go on their steadfast onto the sunnah and the sunnah of the Sahaba Ikram and the times of fitna, who are whatever the people say to them. So you might hear people saying, oh, this person is not following our traditions, so he is so and so. They might say, oh, he is Wahhabi, he is this, he is this. But don't forget, my brothers, every single imam who came, every great imam, look at Imam Ahmed bin Hanbel, unko kitne kore pade the to speak the truth. You will have haters. You will have haters. You will have people who will dislike what you are saying. But you have to speak the truth. Every single imam who is almost punished for it. You look at the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself. What was he called? He Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ko kya 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 naam unhone banaye the? Kahin, ye to kahin hai. He's a poet. Okay, so these are the kind of names. So we will also see this. Don't think when you are following the sunnah and you are following the ways of the Sahaba ikram, it's going to be a nice and easy path. No, you will also get called names. You will also get called out, oh, this person is following this way, he is wrong, this. But you have to stand fast. You have to be sabit qadam. Qul amantu billahi summa istaqim. You have to say, the Prophet ﷺ said, say, I believe in Allah and be steadfast on his deen. You have to follow the sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ. This is no other option. If there was any other option and there was another way to make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala happy, the Sahaba ikram would have been the first people to show us that way. But they didn't celebrate these kind of things. These are some innovations which carried on from the 517 Hijri. 517 Hijri from the sect which was known as the Fatimiyun. Fatimiyun is the extreme Shia sect which they innovated, and they were following many other birthdays. They were doing the birthday of Imam Hassan, Imam Hussein. They were doing their own Eid, Qadir al-Qum, and they were doing the 10th of Muharram. They were celebrating apne aap ko fitna. Ye sab unki bidat thi. Aista, they on the when it came to the 10th of, or when it came to the 12th Rabiul Awwal, then they said, we are going to now celebrate the Prophet's birthday as well. Why did they do this? Just in today's time, so in today's time, what do you get the prime ministers doing? They are making more festivals. Why do you think the Olympics, why does every country want it in their own country? Why? Because it brings in the money. It brings in the money. This was the same mindset that they had as well. They weren't bothered about anything. So they made Milad, the first time Miladun Nabi was ever done on the face of this earth was the time that by the Shias, 517. And this is not me saying this. I'm not saying this. Look in the books of Tariq. Imam Ibn Kathir Rahimahullah has a book, Bidaya wa Nihaya. You look in there, volume 13 and page 137. It is mentioned the full waqiyat, how this Mawlidun Nabi, how it actually started. So my brother, this is not something from the religion. Later on, after about 100 years, takriban about 650 years, almost 700 years ke baad, Sunni jo dunya thi, unhone bhi aasta aasta ye shuru kiya. And this was one of the badshahs, the governor at that time was Muzaffar Abu Sa'id Kaukaburi. This was the first person, the first governor, who actually first started the Mawlidun Nabi. He was the king of Iraq, he was governor at that time, and he did it with the same mindset that this will bring in the money to my people, this will bring in the festivals, we will get more famous. So they started to progress a lot. Other countries started to see the same. When they started to see that these people are doing well, so they also started to do this. Why did they choose 12th Rabiul Awwal? Rabiul Awwal, 12th Rabiul Awwal, is one of the opinions. There are seven opinions when Rasulullah ﷺ was born. One of them is 12th Rabiul Awwal, even though this has no chain whatsoever. Ibn Ishaq rahimahullah, who came 150 years after the Prophet was after Hijri, he writ about this. He said the birth of the Prophet was 12 Rabiul Awwal. But this is not the most authentic one. The most authentic one has a Tabi'een connected to that. And that is the second Rabiul Awwal. The second Rabiul Awwal is even more authentic than the 12th Rabiul Awwal. And then there is another opinion of Bakar rahimahullah. He mentions that this is the he said the Prophet was actually born in Ramadan. And similarly with Ibn Abdul Barr rahimahullah, he is also on the opinion that Rasulullah wasn't even born in Rabiul Awwal. He was born in the month of Ramadan. So this is the first of all, it is not even clear to us. Second of all, if somebody wants to do shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are all thankful to Allah, the real ashiqi rasul, the lovers of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, are those who follow his sunnah. You change your life. Shouldn't be that a festival, you are the whole act, for example, Mother's Day, ab ek Mother's Day jo ho jata hai, pura jo, what you are supposed to be doing every day. Mother's Day is every day. Father's Day is every day. Yeah, you need to fulfill the hukuk, unke jo hukuk hote hain, aapne pura kare. Isi tarah Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam ki hukuk bhi hai. You have to fulfill the rights of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You have to follow his sunnah. It's not fixed for a festival. You can't just make a festival and think, well, we just do it on this day. But look at the rest of the life, the remaining 12 months, they're empty of the sunnah. We are all thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we must remember the sunnah and the tariqah which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. We cannot start to oppose the sunnah and say that we are sunni. Hum to sunni hai bhai. Sunni ka matlab jo ahle sunnat sahaba ikram aur rasulullah ki sunnat tari bhi kare kehne wale ke aaj bahut milenge. You will find many people who will say we are sunni. Unka sunni ka matlab hi nahi pata. They don't even know the meaning. They are not even following the Quran and sunnah. They are not following the sahaba ikram sunnat. Ab yehi unko, you challenge them on this, there is absolutely no evidence whatsoever. They will never be able, in 100 years, they will not be able to bring you a single hadith or anything which even in the imam, Imam Abu Hanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Shafi, any of the great imma ever celebrated the Maulid like this week. Bidaats, they don't stop here, my brothers, they don't stop here. I just mentioned very muktasar, they don't stop here. They will carry on. Ab yehi aap misal le jo milad ki thi, ab jo aahista aahista yarmi shareef shuru hogi. Where yarmi shareef come from? Yarmi shareef, my brothers, many people are on their delusion, they think that this is something which is giving sadaqah to the poor people. This is not sadaqah to the poor people. Ye Yarmi Sharif, this is the birthday of Abdul Qadir Jilani. Ab unki birthday bhi shuru hogi. Maine jaise shuruaat ki thi, aapko I told the waqia, jo Quraysh the Makkah wale the, unki bidat kahan se shuru hui aur kahan khatam hui. To ye bhi aap bidat dekh le ke yahan aahista aahista kahin kahin urs banaye ja rahe hain. Ye Rasoolullah ka hukm tha. Was this what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said? Did sahaba ikram ever do this? Jo sahaba ikram aur Rasoolullah sallam ne kiya hai, unhone kaha wohi karo. I told you very clearly, like a chakir midan, like a very clear barren land, the sunnah is very clear to you. Seera, jo hai Rasool Salam ki, wo sirf Rabiul Awwal mein shuru hona, bas yehi mukarrar karna, yeh theek nahi hai. Rabiul Awwal ke mahine aap shuru kar dein, lekin pura saal usko mukammal karein. We need to live, we need to know the Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam all our life. Ye sirf Rabiul Awwal ke mahine mein muktasar nahi hona chahiye. So it should be something which is throughout the year. We need to learn, we need to know who Rasulullah was. If he only specified for 1 month, but what about Sikhiya bus? So all through the year, we should be learning about Rasulullah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to act upon once again from our arena in the barah.